just for the ones that think I'm joking. Yeah, this one real for real. Like we bust off half a pass. Yeah, I'm sweating, baby. Must be all them happy meals. I don't know how happy feels, but damn, I'm trying to find out. Say I got sex appeal. I think it's cause I wear a fat gun. I'm ready to race. No, I don't fear none. I'm stuck in my ways. They say I'm the chosen one. To see it in my face. Get this one and I'm holding on. I can't be replaced. I just take a shit when it's bit. We on chat.
Sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around, it's like the hell on the clock. Are you irresponsible without your money or not? Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around, just like the hands on the clock.
Come like a bat out of the hell, I dare you to cross like a reverend. And my energy paralyzed, I'm like I'm finger 11. Take a second, I'm finna send it like a parent. A message to the best, if it ain't me, then you need you a confession. You a mess, you ain't scary to me. Heard you was a leader, but that ain't apparent to me. Put dust on you, a cheater, run up, and I'm airing the scene. Not just like Vegeta Prince, and I'm an heir to the seat.
I mean, for real. Touch the driver's saw so I don't even grab the wheel. That's all on my chest, but it don't mean a man is stealing. Man, I'm walking with some money, man, I mean a couple mil. Ew, think you need a mail. You ain't even eating while I'm feasting in the field. That's why I'm always cheesing, cause I feel like Uncle Phil. And all this loose think the freshman ain't happy, man, as well.
Are you irresponsible without your money or not? Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around, just like the hell on the clock. Are you irresponsible without your money?
I guess I'll fuck you guys when we get here. It's shaking forever, bro. I'm shaking now. I won in the regular season, but that's a regular season, like, oh my god, he showed up, yo Cheddar, what is good, take it easy on me, buddy, just calm down here, it's nothing too deep, here we go. Jalen Reagor. That's one more corner than I can. Oh my god. Yeah, you're ball. No, why am I gonna ball it?
Great one in store between the Cleveland Browns and the Indianapolis Colts.
Rocky and I have to go get a back. Rocky and I have a big back. Yo, Bills beat Patrick Patriots. No, well, there's new face. Good run. I enjoyed that.
A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run, and let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs
in the league. I enjoyed that one. That was fun.
Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down. Otherwise, it's going to be a long afternoon.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Now Mayfield.
Bro, got through there. I mean, that was risky, though, yeah.
That one unable to develop. A loss of a couple, and it's second down.
Playing, man.
From the gun, Mayfield. Look at this one across the 45 before he's brought down. His first reception of the divisional round matchup, but it's good for a first down as well. First down. From the shotgun, it's Mayfield.
Good.
This all the way down inside the 35. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
I don't care who you put on him, he's going to be a handful in one-on-one throws.
Yeah, right now, you're right. They're in man-to-man, maybe need some safety.
What's called? Miracle on that side makes it impossible to play man like that because he can't, like...
Now from Colts territory, here's a first
he can't, like, what's it called?
Down at the 33. Going to the air again with Mayfield.
He can't play. He can't put that safety down. He can't put that safety down to guard on an Odell crossing.
They like that.
They don't just like it. They love it because now everyone gets locked in.
I'm gonna be low key quiet today.
Everyone's easy about what they're doing
out
there.
It's freaking cheddar,
man. They're looking at the sideline, thinking to themselves and expressing, "Let's keep throwing it. We're doing pretty well."
On second down. It's Elliott, and he'll take this down just shy of the 25-yard line. 3 yards is half of what they needed. Now can they get the other three here on third down?
Well, that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That was a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short gain.
For the Colts, an extra defensive back in there now on third down. Working out of the gun, Mayfield. He's got his man, that's Hardman. And he is going to have a Browns first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. His first reception of the divisional round matchup, but it's good for a first down.
Look, I could have waited for a second, got a touchdown.
Side of the ball, held him to a gain of two, and that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and eight, now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
Last run good for two. Here's second and eight. Mayfield.
I was lagging so hard right there. Jeez. I literally couldn't even see.
6'5", 332 finds his way home for the sack.
Enough takes to start to have a good drive. Quite like a big loss on a sack, does it?
No, now they're looking at a third.
Like, I would have at least got rid of the ball. Jeez.
Shifted to the other side of the football.
And old Mo is a very, very fickle man.
Mayfield and this Browns offense staring at a third and long now after the sack. Mayfield now.
What a dot by Odell. What a dot, bro. Oh, it's 15! Fourth and two. I'm going to call a play. And I'm going to see what he comes out in. This is a man coverage. He's gonna run to Odell. He's covering Odell right now. As much as I like this look, I'm gonna play smart here. I needed seven there. Jeez. I put Ward on Campbell and then Greedy on either Agnew or Rager. And then that will also put
They'll throw on first down with Trubisky. Flushed out right.
No way he did that.
5 yards shy of midfield. That one goes for 24 yards.
I should have stopped him.
We talk about mobility of quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and is accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
A big play to start him out. Has him at the 45 already.
Let's go.
And he got blown up, losing yardage on the play back at the 44. That one unable to develop, never got going. A loss of a couple, and it's second down. Up. At the 44-yard line. Snap it at one. Now it's Trubisky. This one caught by Davis. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. Number 85. A gain of 9. Brings up 3rd and 3.
I'm playing the run first.
They had the catch on second down, but it didn't.
No. Reset play. Bro, here. I fluffed it. Maybe not, maybe not. Oh, yes, I did. I definitely did.
Once more, it's Trubisky.
Oh, I should have told him. What's that one? UT?
First down as they convert on 3rd and 3 with a nice gain of 7 yards.
Look, I almost could have. I could have licked that. Who's 87? Why is he so open on that? I should be able to guard that. Frick. And it matches Richard. It looks like 6. Good.
And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. 2nd and 10 coming up. Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. And trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
Lock on fire, so I take a cost.
Looking to throw on 2nd down. Trubisky steps away to his left. And that is
defense, boys.
Trubisky had his first incompletion after a 4-for-4 start.
Johnny Bay, it is a 10 and a
half. I like the play call right out of the gate. I like the tone that they're setting. Do what that direction.
And then it's good. Stretch gang, put in work. God, I can't hear my music, but just know I'm vibing. Vibing to this 4th down stop. My film, you feel me?
They had the incomplete pass on 2nd down. Now they need a big play here. 3rd and 10.
Oh, he messed up. I have to accept that. I'm sorry. I have to accept that. I feel like that wasn't fluke, but he actually like hit people time with this, because he's out here motioning cross receivers and stuff. You know what I'm saying?
I think he was as surprised as maybe his bench was.
This is even farther if I get this up, bro. What is he gonna do here?
After the delay, they're backed up even further for 3rd and long.
Can I get on facts? Can I get on Baisley, bro?
This is Hines.
Hey!
And he can only manage to take the football to the 40.
4th and 9. Let's go.
Shy of the first down marker. They'll get 6 there on the run.
Good decision, Cheddar. Good decision, Cheddar.
Here now,
good decision. Ooh,
he hit from 62 in his rookie season.
Good decision, Cheddar.
I respect that. So call it a,
he make that. Oh, yeah. All right, good decision.
57 yards out. That was bombs away right there. These kickers now, it's like we take them for granted. Kicks like that used to be such a big deal, and now you just expect them to make it.
Yeah, you're exactly right, and we shouldn't take them for granted. But I have a theory about it. You want to hear?
Yeah.
They are more athletic now than ever before. Talk about kickers. Trace their backgrounds, trace their histories. You'll find that they were big-time athletes all along, but their kicking was so prevalent that we made them specialists.
I'm sorry, it's some 60-year-old named Baisley throwing live into the ground. Facts, though. I don't know, it's facts. I mean, it's facts, though. It's facts, though.
Drive about to get started. And they had a long drive last time, but they had to settle for a field goal. And I'm sure that's how it felt to them, settling. They probably should have gotten in the
I'm scared.
Yeah, not all now joy, right? Because that's what you get when you put the ball in the end zone.
What is he, blitzing everybody?
To that type of a long drive. Your defense gets a chance to take a break, adjust a little bit, maybe get themselves ready to get back out on the field and play a little bit better. So they'll take the benefit even though they wanted the 6 points.
And maybe wore down the other defense. We'll see. From the 29, Mayfield, and they get him down.
What a ball.
Before he takes it across the 40-yard line. His first reception of the divisional round matchup, but it's good for a first down as well.
The Browns' first down.
My mama said.
Throwing, Mayfield. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. That he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. That one good for 20 on the catch and run.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
A first down carry by Elliott. And they're able to get this one past the 30 down to the 25. Another strong gain on the last two plays. They moved it a combined 33 yards.
First down, Cleveland.
They had to settle for three last drive, hoping this second go-around ends in six. In good position, first and 10. But deep on the ground with Elliott. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
Throwing on second and 8, Mayfield. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield.
Oh, go Zeke. Go Zeke, fight!
Inside the 10 to the
fight, Zeke!
Stride, they've got another first down. Great mix of play.
Fight, Zeke.
So far, three runs, three passes. All three passes have been completions. First and goal.
I think on defense now, you have to almost take a chance. Rely on your scouting.
There's no way, because I was lagging. He saw that. Yo, he's going to take it to the house. I cannot believe this. I had the perfect drive. And I stole it because I was being lazy on my reads. Like, I seen him there, I saw him there, like, I was like, okay, all right, whatever, he's not going to get there. And then I lagged for half a second so that he got there. Literally, I was being so lazy on my reads, bro. Nah, I was being so lazy on my reads. But if I could tie it up here, I'd be blessing. I was being so easy on that. Dead ass. That's my bad. I literally watched him come down and pick that. I mean,
The Browns drive about to get started. And following the pick six, and they have decent field position in throwing that pick six. We'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit. There. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably
come on, let's go.
A little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back in.
But they told us, they've got confidence.
Let's get it.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
Who is that random wide receiver running with Odell Beckham Jr.? Make it make sense, please. It's Odell Beckham Jr. Like, I gotta keep it PG because, you know, like, there's kids on my stream. I'm pro. I could go pro if I wanted to.
Here's another first and 10. Second down.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
A second down throw for Mayfield. Escaping the pressure right. And bringing it in right side is Beckham. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one. Now the Browns signal for the second of their timeouts. As they'll stop it with
what
just
do I
want
to call here,
to go in the
Teddy?
First half.
What do you want to call here, Teddy? What do you think is the best choice of?
I see an extra defensive back on the field. A little surprise here on third and one. Mayfield with it once more.
There's no way. It's Odell. It's Odell. That's ridiculous. That's Odell Beckham, bro. That's Odell, bro.
Bring up what I think for the offense, an unexpected fourth down here. So they'll say no to the 50-yard field.
Who is that, bro?
Instead, the offense out there, they're going for it.
Really, man? So you're playing man right now? Alright. Who's guarding Njoku, though? God, please give me an animation with Odell. And he did, 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 and he did.
And mark him at the five. Now the Colts going to burn the second of their timeouts. As the clock stop with 18 seconds to go in the first half. Chance now to get even before the break as they come up first and goal. They'll throw again. Here's Mayfield to the end zone, but it's incomplete. The intended receiver was Rashard Higgins, but it'll be second and goal.
Leads to second and goal.
They've been in the red zone three times, and it's yielded just 3 points. Can they find the end zone here on second and goal? On second down.
Let's go.
It's Elliott.
Needed
in.
That.
Touchdown.
I made up for my earlier mistake.
Touchdown. Ezekiel Elliott. As the first half is winding down, and the Browns are within an extra point of tying this thing up. Cody Parkey is on now for the point after.
My Stevie Wonder throw. Jeez. Alright, so that kind of just erased my mistake. If I scored, like, when I, if I, off that pick series drive, if I scored, the chances come down to stop him again were half.
All level now at 10 apiece as the kick's away. This will make it into the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
So I'm
at their own 19-yard line.
Wow. I've been playing, like, I've been moving the ball pretty well, so. Get three. You only have the ball one time. You know what I'm saying?
And you gotta think, if this is anything other than
just taking a knee,
I'd be very surprised.
What are the chances he gets three here?
Oh, he's running. Why do anything else?
Anxious moment or two there, but they do.
Timeout. Well, that's pretty much it. But yeah, like, mentally, I'm like, come here and stop him, you know? But that's a big if. Like, that's a huge if. Like, oh, he's coming out iPhone. He definitely has some glitch, but actually, yeah. What am I doing? Don't do that. Oh, he wants to take that? I tackle the kid.
Taken down here, lead us to the end of the first half of play. All So it's on to halftime in this AFC divisional round matchup. As we send you down,
bro, he said, nah, this is scripted.
Coachman has our EA Sports.
That is scripted.
Report.
It's not scripted, Coach. Dog.
Winner go home. That's the name of the game. Second half of this AFC divisional round. To return, here's Agnew. And he'll get it up just past the 20 as these guys will go to work at the 21-yard line.
At their own 21-yard line.
The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. They have a chance to break our tie here as we get a look at the first drive of quarter three.
And it's such a tone setter, isn't it? Because both sides trying to seize momentum to begin the half. What do they have dialed up that'll give them an advantage to move the ball downfield?
Let's find out what they have dialed up. This will be taken in by Michael Pittman. And he'll be corralled right around the 34. First play of the drive going for 14 and a first down.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
Now Trubisky on first down. Flush to his right. And that's going to be incomplete. So, Charles, tie game here. What are your keys as we continue to play this second half?
I know people think it's always trite when you say the same things over and over, but they're tried and true in the game of football. Who's going to block better? Who's going to tackle better? In this case, to me, it's turnovers. You've got to take care of the football in order to win the game.
Second and 10 now. It's Trubisky. He's going to sling this deep downfield. And that's going to be too high. Out of bounds and incomplete. He was looking for his running back, Nyheim Hines. But now it'll be third down.
Brings up a third down and 10 yards to go.
Good pack.
Double team and it's intercepted. Picked up by Carl Joseph. And the possession is theirs at their own 43-yard line. First possession of the third quarter, an interception, so maybe a second-half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into the
I'm playing cover two all game. You know what I'm saying? I had to switch it up. I was sitting in that cover too. It was kind of embarrassing, I'm not gonna lie. I was kind of embarrassed.
But we have not seen much on offense from either side these last few drives. It has been a struggle, hasn't
it? Oh, what is that?
Now, if you're on offense trying to get things
figured what
out,
is that?
We self-scout every week in our game plan. How many things do we do at certain times? What are our tendencies? Time to go to some of those tendency breakers and try and create some offense.
They always have those in their back pocket, don't they?
You have to. And if you don't keep abreast of what you're doing, you lock into a rhythm and make it easy for the opposition.
Looking for tendency breakers right now. Now a throw here on second down, and that's complete. And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
10th carry now for Elliott. And this winds up a gain of 4 to the 41.
Brandon, we just saw the benefits of being able to run the ball successfully. They pick up 4 yards on that carry. So now, if you're a play caller, you can do just about anything you want. But on the defensive side of the ball, you scramble a little bit. Now you're behind trying to figure out, do I need to blitz him? Do I need to pressure him? How do I gain an advantage on this snap?
From the 41, Mayfield completes it to Hardman. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
Now on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. Now Mayfield. The Colts D sticking to their assignments, and that brings up fourth. And the other day they told us, when we've got third and five or less, we have to be able to convert. And I guess every team would say that, Charles, but an opportunity miss there.
What they were trying to tell us is they believe it's a matchup game at that point, and they liked some matchups that they had, thought they could exploit them, unable to do so on that play.
So coming on now is the field goal unit. They're going to try for three, and he'll need all the leg he's got here. This will be from 56 yards out. And his kick is good. He got every bit of that one, as it's good from 56 yards out. These kickers now, it used to be that a 50-plus yarder was cause for celebration, now seemingly automatic.
Yeah, isn't it funny? When we prepare for a game, when you look at the backgrounds of these kickers, it's interesting, isn't it, to find out they were All-State quarterbacks, receivers, defensive backs, All-State wrestlers, right, baseball players. We're finding athletes all along, and now they're just specialists putting it through the posts.
At their own 21-yard line. The Indy offense at the line and set to go. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or do you just throw that out the
window? I'm in, what's it called? I'm in a four-man down. There's four heads down there. That should not, like, I mean, I should recognize the formation. Formrack is, come on, Teddy, Formrack. But still,
see how they attack him here. A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. Now Trubisky, buying time to his left. The toss here completed to Pittman. And he'll take this from 147-yard line to the other. A gain of 6.
I think that should have been chalked up as a winning play for the defense, and they somehow beat it, didn't they? Right-handed quarterback flush to his left, yet he finds his tight end on the left side of the field. That's a tough throw. What a great completion.
To throw again on second down, Trubisky. He rifles one, it's intercepted.
Bro, what am I supposed to do about that?
The Browns drive about to get started. And they split the uprights last time for three. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking, because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it? Touchdowns.
Throwing on second down. Mayfield taking it deep. This is caught inside the 15. And all the way in. Touchdown, Cleveland. Touchdown. Mecole Hardman, 53 yards. And the Browns add on to their lead. They talked about stringing together some explosive plays here in the playoffs. That was a pretty explosive play.
It certainly was. And if you're going to win on the road, it certainly helps to have big playability in your hip pocket, doesn't it?
And his guys will take a 10-point lead.
Makes the score Browns 20, Colts 10.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. To return, here's Agnew. And not a very good return at all, as he won't even get this back to the 15.
The Colts take over first and 10 at their own 14-yard line.
Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. And in enemy territory last time through the interception. We'll see what they do on this drive.
Can't wait to see how it alters what they decide to do in play calling. Do they continue to throw the ball? Do they want to lean more on the running game? The interesting sequence of plays that they've got coming up.
Does it often affect the play calling with the interception? How much does that change what you do?
I think it does depending on why the interception was thrown. Sometimes it's just a matter of the defense made a great play, so you continue to come back. But if it's on you, if the offense just doesn't have the confidence, if they're a little bit shaky, maybe try and take the pressure off and run the ball a little bit.
On first down, Trubisky flushed out right. He'll get this one to Pittman. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Indianapolis moving the chains there on a gain of 12.
As a general rule, offensive linemen like to know where their quarterback's going to be when he's setting up to throw the football. And sometimes they just have to get on the run, get on the move. He was able to do that on that play and picks up a first down with a nice throw.
On first and 10, it's Trubisky. And incomplete as he was knocked as he threw it. And it took the ball off course.
You get the sense that they're saying, we're not playing up to what we're capable of, and we're deep enough into the game that the early jitters are long gone, that they should now have some sense of continuity and be able to make some of these plays that they have not been doing so far.
Second and 10 here as we sit in the third quarter of this divisional round matchup. They go play action. Trubisky. Oh, he dropped it. They were looking for him in the middle third. He couldn't catch it. Now third down. But the passing windows are just not there. That's just another example of how great this defense has been all game long.
And that's exactly what a top 10 defense can do. They can really change the game tempo and frustrate you as you try to execute offensively.
Trubisky. He'll find Hines out of the backfield. And he's going to be stopped here at the 43, and that is not near enough to pick up the first. 5 yards, not enough, and it'll be fourth down. Here we go on fourth down with Trubisky. Oh, did he hang on to it? He did on the dime. Nice play.
I don't want to put. I could have put a zone there.
Here's first and 10. Here's Hines. And some room
over. Ridiculous. Okay. How did two people miss right there?
Hines. And that'll hurt the average
side.
Is this time they're able to get him behind the line. Miles Garrett showing that athleticism as he gets in to make the play.
Sometimes you just sit back and marvel at what he can do defensively. Speed, strength,
better activate playoff greatness. No, it's more like, well, Teddy's stout.
That loss of three, a rare stumble on a promising drive. Here, second and 13. From the shotgun is Trubisky. And his pass incomplete.
Incomplete on the throwaway. Brings up third down and 13.
Turn me up. Turn me up. I run the ball here. And it's okay.
The Colts on third down. They've only converted once in four tries. This is going to be third and 13. From the gun, it's Trubisky. That's incomplete, but there is a flag down. So hang on. A big call coming on third down. And if you're going to get rid of it, you better get outside the pocket.
You have to get outside of that tackle box, right? Get out there, and then you can do it legally. But he wasn't able to do so, and they end up losing the down as well.
So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. On the right hash, officially this will be a 51-yard attempt. And his kick is absolutely perfect. And that will tighten this one up a bit. Now a one-score game at 20-13. All right, so they needed two scores to get back in the game. The field goal there, maybe not exactly what they wanted, but the necessary first step.
There's still time remaining, and there's enough time to get it done. They've got to get at the least a three and out here to get the ball back, preferably the takeaway.
All I need to do here is sell.
On the opening play of the drive and also give them a first down.
And the Browns first down.
Stop. I know, it's literally in my mental right now, bro. He literally, I'm thinking, I'm like, yo. Oh my god, I could run outside.
At the line of scrimmage and taken down.
No
gain on the play there, second down. Run blitz there defensively, something we might see more of here in the fourth quarter.
I think we'll see a lot of it, and the difference between that and a pass blitz, you're just trying to get to the quarterback. You're trying to scheme someone open who will get to the QB and make sure he gets on the ground. In a run blitz, you're actually trying to cover up gaps, trying to cover up holes so they can't run the football.
Drops incomplete, but if he was hit a fraction sooner, it may have been a fumble.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. On third down, Mayfield.
You have to guard that. You have to guard that. You have to guard that.
They're able to get the third down conversion.
When teams practice their plays during the week, they're hoping that it's going to pay off on game day. So it sure has to feel good for them when they hit them during a game, and they hit that one there for big yardage.
So the big play gets them all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he's taken down after a gain of three as they move it.
This ball is not
the 19. The excellent play last time.
All I gotta do is take three here. And he has to whatever, two possessions or whatever. Yeah, this ball's not seeing air. I hope you guys understand that. I'm going to pound this rock down his throat until he takes on it.
They go to Elliott again. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. That one, a first down pickup of 8. How about this offensive line? They're really starting to establish themselves, take over this game.
And before the series began, I know exactly what was said in the defense.
Bro, is
bubble.
He good? Bro, I'm scared of standing
there. 3 and out. Let's get off the field. Instead, they can't find any traction towards doing that. Right now, they're just getting muscled all over the field and getting pushed down it.
Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. They go back to Elliott.
I'm running. I wouldn't trigger their inside stuff.
Able to stay in bounds, and the clock keeps running rolling. And this
like,
defense right now, backed up in the red zone. Another touchdown.
Like power plays, traps, like those type of plays don't like.
All you're doing when you're talking to your defensive teammates is
inside runs. They're like a separate thing. They're considered like power run and trap run. So that's why I'm running.
One more score.
Plays header. It's a great way to blow ass. Thanks, man.
Of the football and here as we get you reset. They've got a second down now as they search for a way to get this one to the finish line. On second down.
Jesus.
And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage.
Dude, I'm going to run the ball again, dude. Like, I don't care.
And it leads to a third down.
And now third and goal coming up. The loss on second down. That just means this crowd's going to get even louder, and they'll get a little bit of extra help from the defenders as they exhort them to join them in the effort.
On third down, Elliott.
Get in.
Get into the end zone for a Browns touchdown.
Touchdown.
Ezekiel Elliott, his second touchdown of the afternoon.
Get in, Zeke.
6 to their lead.
Well, that was absolutely ideal for them, wasn't it? Trying to salt this game away. I think one of my kids just graduated in the amount of time they had the football. That was absolutely impressive.
Everybody wants those salt away the game drives. What makes them successful?
But when you're able to mix run pass, when you're able to control the football and stay ahead of the
bro.
Chains, I'm using every cliche I know.
Cheddar, stop!
But that's how you get it done, because you're not taking negative.
I'm not going for two.
And that way you're able to run what you want to run when you get
I'm not going for two.
It.
Why do you why would I go for two?
And the lead is up to 14.
Makes the score Browns 27, Colts 13.
You deserve it. I get love, but I'm still serving. I see you lurking.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away.
Good.
To return, here's Agnew. And he takes this near the 25. Just a little pass there.
He's not. I think he's either.
So the Colts take over first and 10 at their own 26-yard line.
The Indy offense at the line and set to go. And a methodical drive last time, but they couldn't get that knockout blow. They had to settle for 3.
But you gotta like what they've been doing along the way, right? It's almost like the body blows, the setup punch.
That was
they didn't get the knockout blow here, but that doesn't mean it can't come later in the game on another possession. And the defense on the other side,
maybe a little gas.
Yeah, a little tired. And if nothing else, they just feel relieved getting upfield and giving up 3. They don't exactly feel like they've handled the offense.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Now it's Trubisky. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Miles Garrett in there to take him down, and the clock will roll. And we say it all the time, have to be able to get rid of the ball sooner than that.
You have to help your offensive line out. They're going to protect you as best they can. And if you're getting 3 to 5 seconds to throw the ball, they're doing a really nice job. But when you hold it and give up a sack, you're really almost discrediting their work.
On second down, it's Hines. And he'll work free from one tackle, but that's about all as he's taken down. Give him 5 yards on the run there, but it'll leave him with a definite third and long on the horizon.
Yeah.
have secured a spot in the conference championship, and now you can start to smell it at this point in the season, can't you?
You really can, because the focus has been one game at a time, not looking ahead. But when you get to the conference championship game and you know you're there, the Super Bowl does loom in the future.
So that'll do it for us. For my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hard-working men and women on our crew, I'm Brandon Gaughan. You've been watching the NFL right here on EA Sports. So long, everybody.
Really good. He played good. Receiving, that huge third down conversion to Miracle that set up the Zeke touchdown.
Just a heel, ain't nothing just a heel.
Who's the boss? Been moved and zoned.